Hello and welcome back to the training. So in this video, what I'd like to share with you is yet another method for finding expired domains. But now what we want to do is leverage yet another tool in order to find even more niche specific, however, but hopefully more powerful URLs. So here's what we're going to go ahead and do. We are going to leverage a tool. All right. And the tool could be of your choosing. So what I'm going to be using for this demonstration is going to be SEMrush, but if you're an Ahrefs user, a Moz user, a Majestic user, it's completely irrelevant. But what we're going to need to do is determine who our top competitors are. All right, so you know your niche, but let's say you want to rank, whether you're an e-com site, whether you're a local site, whether you're an affiliate site, it doesn't matter. We need to establish who our competition is, and then we want to go ahead and utilize and leverage SEMrush in this case in order to find other prospects for getting expired domains. And then here's how this is done. It's quite simple, really. So what we need to do is we need to figure out, okay, what's our niche? What keywords do we want to start ranking for, right? So this will help us determine who our top competition is. So here's what you will want to do. This is, again, just one more method of doing this. So what you can do here is say you want to rank for, and I had some examples here already, we're going to do best cameras under 1,000. This way it makes sense for local, affiliate, or e-com. So say it's going to be best cameras under 1,000. All right. So some of our top competitors are going to be this RT Rings. It could be Digital Camera World, DP Review. Let's say it's digitalcameraworld.com. So what we're going to want to do is go ahead and grab digitalcamera.com. Okay. And what you can do here is come over, throw this inside of here, go to search. It's going to pull up the referring domains. We're going to click on referring domains. All right. And what we're going to actually do here is we're going to sort these by authority score. So what we're going to do is we know that these are hyper-specific, or more importantly, being rewarded by Google, and they're specific to this niche, right? And even if they're not specific, we know that this site is being rewarded for one of the keywords that we want to rank for, right? So here's what we'll do. What we're going to do is we're going to sort from 45 to 100, all right? So once we sort the referring domains by 45 to 100 or whatever metric you're using, like, you know, you want to go probably DR35 or higher. In this case, it's going to be authority score 45 or higher. Okay. And what we want to do here is we do want to sort by active. Okay. And then we actually want to exclude TLDs that are .edu. Okay. Or education, .gov, okay, we don't want any .govs, and we don't want any .vc. It's either VC or VE, it's one of those, like, you can't register them, okay, so we will apply that, and we're just going to dwindle it down just a little bit more. So we have 3,900. So what I want to do is I would actually want to resort this and get a little bit stronger here. And what we're going to do is go 50. So 50 to 100, these are some of the best links possible. This site has a lot of URLs. So again, I'm looking to get if it has to be stronger, that's fine. But I generally don't want a list this big. I'm not saying that you can't use a list this big. You could, but it's going to take forever. So here's what I would do. What I would do is I would take these. This is another piece. So what I want to do here is I want to actually add another, and I want to exclude by country. I basically want to exclude anything that's not US or anything that's not American speaking. Okay, so you're going to want to desort these. All right, so anything that you don't want that's not relevant for you, you want to get rid of it. Again, we're trying to curate the best list possible because what we're going to do is we're going to use these as seed sets in order to find ourselves some very high quality sources. So what we're going to do is we're going to exclude all of these. Okay. Bear with me here. You can leave Ireland. They speak English, Israel, India, Iran. Okay. Malaysia. Okay, so we're getting rid of a lot of the junk here. New Zealand can stay. Peru. Poland. Okay, here we go. So again, we're switching these up. All right, we're getting rid of all this stuff. Definitely want to leave that. Okay, now we can apply that filter. Now let's see what we got. Aha, 1300. Perfect. Now what we want to do is go ahead and export this to a Excel file. All right, and then what I like to do is I'll come over here, go to Drive. I'll grab this file, Downloads, bring this over here. I'll take this, put it right here like that. I'll open it up. All right, and then what I can do here is I can clean this. So what I can do is I'll go here, here, here. So I know that these are IPs of very high quality. So I'm just gonna, oh my goodness gracious. Let's just go ahead and delete this column. And then we can delete these. All right, now delete this, delete the row. And then I can just go like this, copy, open up your tool, bring this up, go to upload these domains. We'll do copy A, delete, control V, put all those URLs in there. Why are these .edu's in here, I wonder? In any case, what I'll do is I'll go to update. And then when I have a bigger list like this, what I'll do is I'll go in here and I'll go to options. I'll go to my crawler settings and I'll bring this down to about a 4 or a 3. It depends on how much time or if I have a VPS that I'm going to let it run. Make sure my proxies are on. And then what I'll do is metrics, disable all, because I'm just trying to get a scrape here to figure this out. And then what I want to do is, yep, this is good. This is good. Use proxies for crawler. All right. So, and then we'll just fire this baby up and let it start processing. So it's going to take a very long time, but what we're going to do is we're going to scrape because, and here's why we're doing this. Because if this is the top competitor for our niche, ranking for our keywords, we went into their backlink profile, we've exported their best links from their best TLDs, and now we're searching all of their links for other, we're searching it, you know, 3-4 levels deep, looking for expired domains that are in the link graph. These are highly relevant URLs from very high-powered relevant sites. So this is another method. I gave you the full walkthrough of how you would go about doing this. This is yet another way to find expired domains. And this is getting more niche specific and a little bit more potent, but that's another metric or another method for you. All right. So I look forward to seeing you in the next training and I'll see you then. Goodbye.